in the lab room, and we're going to tell you about the red storage bins,
where they're located, what's in them, and to always remember to put your equipment away so you know where to find them when you need them. You can find odds and ends in three different red storage bins in the lab. Just look around. One red storage bin is located in the storage room. The second set of red storage bins is found in the corner of the lab. And the third set is found in the back of the laboratory. Next, you're probably wondering, what's in the red storage bins? In the red storage bins, you'll find small items, such as odds and ends, and items that you don't use all the time, and items that you won't find at your lab station. There's nothing like being in the middle of a project and not being able to find the equipment that you need. So you go over to the red storage bins and find an empty red storage box. And don't forget, when you're done with your materials, put them away. And you'll keep your lab clean. Okay, now I hope that we could help you out a little bit more and you know a lot more about the red storage bins. I hope you will always remember where they are, what's in them, and to always remember to put your equipment away, because you need to know where everything is, and it's kind of frustrating when you can't find stuff. And you always want to keep your laboratory clean.
Hey, Scorps, what's up? This is Amanda.
I'm Tracy.
And I'm Courtney, and we're going to teach you the right and wrong ways to dispose of waste.
Have you ever lit a match before and wondered where to put it?
Or have you ever cleaned up a spill and wondered where the paper towel goes? If you've ever wondered these things, here is the answer.
Follow these simple and easy steps, and you will be on your way to a cleaner chemistry lab.
Once you light a match for one of your labs, and after you put it out, don't throw that awful match in the sink. That is a big lab no-no. It plugs up the sink. Instead, after you light the match and then put it out, put the match in the little blue pail next to the sink.
Have you ever had to grab one of these brown paper towels for one of your massive chemical spills?
First things first, the don'ts. You cannot take out the powder vertical, you must hold it horizontal. Do not spill the powder on the table or on the scale. Absolutely no pouring back in. And here is the right way to do everything. Set the bowl on the scale and push tear. Holding the bottle horizontally, take out the powder, put it in the boat, and get ready to weigh. Try to weigh as close to 2 grams as possible. Perfect. Make sure to put the cap back on when you are finished pouring.
This is the project overall done correctly.
Grab the powder from the chemical room. Make sure you take enough float for your project. And take the scooper from the top drawer. Watch as he takes both the powder out horizontally and weighs it perfectly.
When you are done, be sure to put all the equipment away.
It's burning through my hands. Watch out, next time it might not be bleach. Next time it might be a very high concentrate acid that will eat through your skin. In chemistry, you must be very careful when dealing with different chemicals, or the worst might happen.
These are the materials you will be using in the lab for your experiment today. This is the drawer where you will find your cylinder and beaker. This is the small beaker you'll be using today. This is the liquid you will be transferring. Here you see all your materials. The liquid is being poured into the small cylinder. As you can see, they made a big mess. The bleach has been poured into a small beaker and is now being transferred into a cylinder. This is the right way to do liquid transfer. As you can see, the sink is much cleaner and not as time consuming. This is the chemistry lab where you will put into practice what you have learned. And as we all know, practice makes perfect.
Hello Scorps, today we will be showing you how to clean the glassware in the lab. We will show you in explicit detail how the cleaning process should be done. There are steps to how you clean the glassware the correct way. In conclusion, if you don't clean glassware the correct way, you can cause chemicals to get mixed and mess the project up. So it is very important to know what you are doing in the lab at all times.
First of all, you will grab the glass you will be cleaning and dump all of the contents inside the glass out. Then you will rinse the glass off. Get a brush appropriate to the glass size. Then you will take the brush, dip it in the soap substance, and scrub the inside of the glass as well as the outside of it. When you are done cleaning the glass, rinse the soap suds off. Then use distilled water as the final rinsing stage. If the distilled water makes a sheet, then we're done rinsing it with the distilled water. If it doesn't make a sheet, then you have to redo this whole process over again. When you are done, the bigger glasses go on the shelves. Smaller glasses go on the top or second shelf. And two butt glasses will go in the third drawer.
When you finish using any glassware, it is appropriate to clean it and put it where it belongs. If and only if you don't have time, make sure you put the glass in the sink before leaving the class and tell the teacher so he or she can clean the glassware.
We're here in the chemistry lab. Chemistry can be a fun and exciting experience, or it can be a dangerous experience. Pay attention as we show you how to clean up a broken thermometer.
When you break a thermometer, mercury usually spills all over. Remember, mercury is a poison, so don't touch the mercury. The mercury disposal box is located on your right as you enter the science lab. Inside the disposal is a sponge. Use this sponge to carefully soak up the mercury. After you have soaked up all of the mercury in the sponge, rub the sponge against the grate that is located inside the disposal box. When you have finished, put the sponge back in the mercury disposal. Screw the lid back on the disposal. Make sure it is tight so it doesn't fall off and spill mercury all over the place.
Now you should know exactly what to do in case you break a thermometer. If you follow all of our steps closely and carefully, you will effectively be able to clean up after yourself. Remember to always use caution when dealing with hazardous chemicals. We hope you enjoyed our film.
We will be instructing you on the proper way to clean up an acid spill, including the proper supplies to use and what to do with the supplies after they have served their purpose. Please do not just abandon the acid after it has been spilled, and if the supplies that are needed are not around, please find help as soon as possible.
Now I collect the equipment required to perform our experiment. Now start mixing the chemicals you are using. Oh no. Sprinkle baking powder over the acid to dissipate it.
Go! Get a sponge!
wet the sponge. Now clean up the area of the spill to make it safe for others to use. Put the sponge in the sink. Clean your work area up. Put away your chemicals. Rinse your equipment off and put it in its proper place.
We have demonstrated that acid can be fun and dangerous at the same time. Acid can be very dangerous in the wrong hands, such as a tyrannical dictator or a master thief. So when you are using acid or other harmful chemicals, please take the proper precautions so as to ensure the safety and well-being of yourself and others around your person. Thank you for watching our incredibly long and boring video on acid and its harmful effects on the human body and mind. And remember, when you're handling chemicals or acid, always use gloves.
In Mr. McDowell's chemistry class, we will show you the proper ways and wrong ways of lighting a Bunsen burner. We will show you you should not light a match right next to the gas and show you that you should not play with the flint lighter. This lab will show you the wrong and right ways of lighting a Bunsen burner. You will turn on the main gas and pull the Bunsen out of the cabinet. My hose is on the nipple. You pull the flint lighter out of the drawer. And you turn on the gas. This is necessary. And in the end, you light the Bunsen burner.
Note to self, there are many smells more delightful than that of the singed arm hair.
When burning plastic, fumes may be toxic. Do not look directly in the light. It will hurt your eyes.
How to fill a graduated cylinder.
Learn how to use a graduated cylinder. We will learn how to properly measure, prevent breakage, and keep you from making stupid mistakes. If the students had paid attention in the first place, you would not have to be watching this stupid film.
When filling the graduated cylinder, you must first pour the liquid almost to the point wanted. Then a dropper must be used so the measurement is exact. Now we'll show you what the collar is used for. By using the collar, the graduated cylinder is not broken, so it always must be used. And remember to clean up your messes.
What happens when the collar is not used?
It may look cool at the time, but paying for it isn't.
Because you could use that money to buy a pet monkey you always wanted.
Listen up, I have some important information about the chemistry lab, room 313. You've looked everywhere. Your grade depends on it. You need it right now, but you just can't find it. We have just a solution for finding lab beakers, so pay attention closely. For my project, I'm going to need a 100mm beaker and maybe some different size glass. Hopefully everything is in the same spot that we left in yesterday. Oh dang it, does anyone know where they are? Because they're not in the same place they were yesterday. Well, now I need to find the glassware I have to use. This is where we find all the glassware for your experiment. They have everything from 100mm beakers to sponges. After your experiment and all your projects, make sure you put all the glassware and other stuff you used away, because the class after you may need the same materials. Oh, there it is. I finally found all the different sizes of glasses. Now, to finally finish the experiment I stated a minute ago, I will have to find the rest of my chemicals later because it took me so long to find the glass because they weren't in the right spot. Now I need a thermometer. Oh, there it is, right in front of me, and it's exactly the one I happen to need. I wish people would always put the stuff back because it took me almost all period just to find the glassware and the thermometer.
Learn to listen. When the teacher tells you where something is and where to put it away, it'll be a whole lot easier to find the materials you need for your experiment, and you will take less time, so you will have time to finish your project.
Well, in here we are going to show you how to use waveboats, the right way, the wrong way, and what could happen if you do it the wrong way. We will be using a beaker, a waveboat, chemicals, and many other things to help out. I hope you enjoy. Here is where you will find the waveboats. Before taking the wayboat out into the lab, here is where you will weigh the chemicals. Wash the rest of the chemicals into the beaker with water. Then throw it away. Someone has left a used wayboat out instead of throwing it away. Another student grabs the used wayboat, not realizing that it has been used.
Here are the two chemicals mixed into the wayboat.
Then the student leaves the wayboat there instead of throwing it away. There is wayboat still left there.
The student pours another chemical into an already used wayboat. The student is pouring another chemical into the wayboat.
Here is the student pouring another chemical in. Boom! The chemicals have made a reaction. So now we know what could happen if we do it the right way and the wrong way. Also, what could happen if you do it the wrong way. So please make sure you do what you are supposed to do instead of causing an accident in the lab.
This is not how you do a dry transfer. And this is not how you do a wet transfer. So clean up those messes that you make. Especially if they're dangerous chemicals. Hey, this is Jared Doss with Scorp TV. Do you hear noises in the science hall, like hiss, pop, bang, and wonder what's going on? Well, wonder no more, because here we are to tell you what those noises are and how to clean up after messes that you make after spilling dangerous chemicals. Don't go straight from a large can to a small cylinder. Or from a bottle to a small cylinder. Now for wet transfers. That's the stuff. Can and beaker. Beaker and cylinder. Spatula and Weibo is what you need for a dry transfer. Tilt the bottle and bring the spatula in. Remember to press the tear button. If you've forgotten where Weibos are, here they are. Here's the powder.
This has been Nathan Ash and Jared Doss reporting for Scorp TV. We have hoped you learned something from what we have explained to you. Now that you have received this information, you should remember how to do a wet and dry transfer. It is important, so go have fun.
It is up to you and only you to decide whether to do the right or wrong things. But keep in mind, if you do the right thing, you will be cool like us. So remember, be cool and dispose of your waste the right way.
Thank you.
Always push the tear button, or as you can see, the weight will come out wrong. Be sure and put the scale back to zero before and after you weigh. Now you're ready to start weighing. Do it carefully. If you happen to spill like I have here, just always be sure and clean up well. Like I said before, put the scale back at zero.
Here is one of the more advanced scales in this lab. But just like any other electronic scale, always push the tear button and proceed on weighing your material.
It's not that hard learning how to balance the proper way with the right care. Do a great job for your teacher, if not for him, for you and your fellow classmates.
This is your chemistry lab. To prevent chemical burn once a spill occurs on the body, go to the emergency shower located in the south of the lab. Stand directly under the head of the shower and pull the triangle handle. Rinse the affected area thoroughly. In case chemicals come in contact with the facial area, use the eyewash sprayer located under the shower head. Push the lever away from the body and put your face directly under the sprayer. When working with dangerous chemicals, do not have horseplay or messing around. To prevent further accidents, mop up the shower area thoroughly. Remember to always rinse out the mop. Always throw contaminated clothes away. Do not attempt to cover up spilled chemicals. Do not take contaminated clothes out of the trash can. Do not hang up contaminated clothes after using them. A paper towel is not sufficient to clean off chemicals. Remember, safety comes first in chemistry class.